Hi everyone, and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session, guys, as usually, we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for all the government exam. So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session, and you can also ask any doubt. And you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which is regarding the Pradhan Mantri Ayushman Bharat Health Infrastructure Mission. So this is something new. And remember, the details of this particular mission have not been provided by the government. Abhi bas Prime Minister ne isko launch kiya hai. It has just been launched by the Prime Minister. We will discuss all the details once it will be released by the ministry. So consider the following statements with respect to PM Ayushman Bharat Health Infrastructure Mission, and you have to identify the correct statement. So first of all, who has launched this? Prime Minister himself has launched Pradhan Mantri Ayushman Bharat Health Infrastructure Yojana from his own constituency Varanasi from UP. ठीक है, वाराणसी से उन्होंने लॉन्च किया है. And also remember that the objective of this scheme is to strengthen the critical health infrastructure. So as the name suggests, health infrastructure mission, matlab that means the objective of this scheme is to develop the health infrastructure and also to, you know, jo existing infrastructure hai usko bhi improve karna, and also to improve the existing infrastructure is the basic objective of this particular scheme. All right, so to strengthen the critical healthcare network from village to block to the district to the regional and national level, which means the government will now focus on health infrastructure starting from village level up to the national level, all right, in the next 4-5 years. Now there are three components of this mission, guys. According to the speech of Prime Minister when it was launched, there are three components of this particular mission. Number one is creation of facilities for diagnostic and treatment. Aisi facilities banayi jayengi jo ki diagnostic aur treatment ke liye kaam hai. In this component, three things will be done. Number one, health and wellness centers will be opened in villages and cities. Number one, health and wellness centers banaye jayenge. This is very basic. Facilities like free medical consultation, free test, free medicine, everything will be provided in these health and wellness centers. And number three, for serious illness, 35,000 new critical care related beds will be added in 600 districts across the country. जो कि कोविड के टाइम में जो बेड की शॉर्टेज हुई थी, तो इन फ्यूचर अगर इस तरीके का कोई पैंडेमिक आता है तो उससे टैकल करा जा सकेगा विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस हेल्थ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. ओके, मूविंग अहेड टू अनदर कंपोनेंट. नंबर टू इज टेस्टिंग नेटवर्क फॉर डायग्नोसिस ऑफ डिजीजेस. 730 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री विल गेट इंटीग्रेटेड पब्लिक हेल्थ लैब्स फॉर यू नो फॉर रिसर्च वगैरह करने के लिए. दीज हेल्थ लैब्स विल बी डेवलप एंड फॉर basically it will be a testing infrastructure like blood test, ECG, EEG, echo test, ye jitne bhi test hote hain in sabhi ke liye these labs will be established across the country in 730 districts. 3000 blocks will get block public health units, and 5 regional national centers for disease control and 20 metropolitan units will be established under the second component. Now talking about the third component, so it is expansion of the research institutes. Now the government is also focusing on the research in this particular area of health. So of course, if we want to do research, then definitely we want some infrastructure. Bina infrastructure ke hum koi bhi research to nahi kar payenge. So for that, 4 new national institutes of virology and 1 national institute for one health will be established under this particular mission. That's it. Till now we only the PIB, the government has only provided this much information. इसके बाद जो भी डिटेल्स होंगी वी विल डिस्कस इट लेटर. सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन इज यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. द स्कीम हैज 3 कंपोनेंट्स. दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय पीएम फ्रॉम वाराणसी. यस, दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट. 4 न्यू नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट्स ऑफ वायरोलॉजी एंड 2 न्यू नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट्स फॉर वन हेल्थ. नो, ओनली 1 नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट फॉर वन हेल्थ विल बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड. सो 1 एंड 2 विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑप्शन ए, ऑप्शन ए, only 1 and 2 guys will be the correct answer. So I hope this is clear. Most probably isme se jo question aayega ya to yahi hoga jaisa ki maine aapko bataya, or otherwise the question will be 1 marker that from where this Pradhan Mantri Ayushman Bharat health infrastructure scheme was launched. So it was launched from Varanasi in UP. Now moving ahead to question number 2. Who has been selected as the chairperson of newly constituted National Steering Committee for implementation of Nipun Bharat mission? So I believe aap sabko yaad hoga that in the month of July this mission was launched by the Ministry of Education. And who is the Minister of Education now? It's Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan, and he is also the Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So this mission Nipun Bharat was launched in the month of July 2021, and there was a provision of National Steering Committee to implement this particular mission, Nipun Bharat. So now this National Steering Committee has been established, and the question is regarding the chairperson of that committee. So it is in news because National Steering Committee has been constituted, has been established, and it will be chaired by Dharmendra Pradhan, Minister of Education. And who will be the vice chairperson? It's Annapurna Devi, who is the Minister of State in Education. Alright, now let's talk about Nipun Bharat ki thodi si baat kar lete hain, sirf objective ki baat kar lete hain. So I believe aapko yaad hoga that in the month of July we have discussed it in very detail that this scheme is all about the enhancing the literacy and numeracy of the children till the grade 3rd. ठीक है, जो ग्रेड 3rd तक के बच्चे हैं उनकी न्यूमरेसी, उनकी जो लर्निंग की एबिलिटी है उसको एनहांस करना इसका बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव है. सो टू क्रिएट एन एनेबलिंग एनवायरनमेंट टू इंश्योर यूनिवर्सल एक्विजिशन ऑफ फाउंडेशनल लिटरेसी एंड न्यूमरेसी, एंड दिस विल बी डन बाय प्रोवाइडिंग रीडिंग राइटिंग एंड न्यूमरेसी स्किल्स टू द चिल्ड्रन बाय द एंड ऑफ ग्रेड 3 बाय द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2027. मतलब द चिल्ड्रन अप टू द ग्रेड 3, ग्रेड 3rd तक के बच्चों को दे विल बी प्रोवाइडेड विद द रीडिंग राइटिंग स्किल्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द न्यूमरेसी एंड दे विल बी प्रोवाइडेड विद द बेसिक लिटरेसी, ओके, अंडर दिस पर्टिकुलर मिशन. एंड दीज आर सम ऑफ द फोकस एरियाज ऑफ दिस निपुण भारत, लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल प्रोवाइडिंग एक्सेस एंड रिटेनिंग चिल्ड्रन इन फाउंडेशनल ईयर्स ऑफ स्कूलिंग. दीज लाइन्स यू कैन यूज इन योर एसे वगैरह में यूज हो सकता है. टीचर कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग, development of high quality and diversified student and teacher resources, learning materials, and then tracking the progress of each child in achieving this literacy and numeracy. Now these lines are not important for the exam. These lines can be used in essays type of things, okay, like for example upcoming RBI NABARD mains mein ya fir RBI mains mein koi agar descriptive question koi aisa aa jata hai to you can use these lines. So therefore guys, the correct answer will be what? Union Education Minister is the chairperson of, has been selected as the chairperson of this newly constituted National Steering Committee for implementing the Nipun Bharat mission. Moving ahead to question number 3. Which of the following is incorrect with respect to Mahatma Gandhi National Fellowship? So it is in news because the second phase of Mahatma Gandhi National Fellowship has been launched under the Sankalp program. Under the Sankalp program of Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, there is a program Sankalp under the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, and under that program these fellowships are being given, theek hai, under the phase 1, and now the phase 2 has been launched. That's why it is in news. So let's talk about this. So as I told you, it has been launched under the Sankalp program of Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, the second phase. Talking more about this, so in the first phase was launched with IIM Bangalore as the academic partner. IIM Bangalore was the academic partner, and currently there are 69 fellows which are doing research under this particular fellowship program. And in the phase 2, 661 fellowships will be deployed. And now the academic partner, in the phase 1 only one IIM was included, and now 8 more IIMs are added. And now the total number of academic partners are 9 IIMs, which are these: IIM Ahmedabad, Jammu, Kozhikode, Lucknow, Nagpur, Bangalore was already there, Vishakhapatnam, Udaipur and Ranchi. No need to remember the name of these 9 IIMs, just remember that there are 9 IIMs which are the partner, academic partner for implementing Mahatma Gandhi National Fellowship program. And total 661 fellowships will be deployed under this particular fellowship of Mahatma Gandhi National Fellowship Program. Okay, So now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the incorrect statement. 69 fellows were deployed in 69 districts across 6 states during phase 1. This is absolutely correct. In phase 1, IIM Ahmedabad was the academic partner. No. In phase 1, only IIM Bangalore was the academic partner, and now total 9 IIMs are the academic partner. So option B will be the correct answer. But let's read out the other options also. In phase 2, 661 fellowships will be deployed. Yes. Total 9 IIMs are deployed in phase 2. Yes. And it is implemented under Sankalp program of Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship headed by Dharmendra Pradhan. So therefore the correct answer, guys, is what? Option B. Moving ahead to question number 4, which is again regarding a scheme. 4 questions, 4 schemes. Consider the following statements with respect to amended technology upgradation fund scheme, and you have to identify the incorrect statement. This is in news because it has been recently reviewed by the Ministry of Textile. So one thing is clear, that this is being implemented by Ministry of Textile, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal. He is a leader in Rajya Sabha. He is the leader of Rajya Sabha. Alright, and who is the leader of opposition? Mallikarjun Khadge of Congress. So this was in news because it has been reviewed by the Ministry of Textiles, and review jo hua hai usme zyada, there is no important points. But yes, agar ye news mein hai, toh we have to discuss about this news. So what is the objective first? Naam se pata chal raha hai, technology upgraded fund scheme. And since it is being implemented by the Ministry of Textile, which means it is for the textile industry. It is for the textile industry. So what is the objective? It is a capital investment subsidy program, which is the subsidy is provided for installing machinery by the industry after physical verification. Okay, basically, in short, if we understand, it is a capital investment subsidy program under which the subsidy is provided for installing new machineries. All right. And of course, it will promote ease of doing business, because once the machines are installed, the business will have a boost, and that definitely business jo hoga wo karna aasan ho jayega, and definitely it will promote the ease of doing business, and it will also promotes the investment in the textile sector. Because kya hota hai ki agar kahin pe subsidy milti hai, whenever there is subsidy which is being provided by the government towards that thing, we attract more. Us चीज की तरफ हम ज्यादा अट्रैक्ट होते हैं, ठीक है? सो उस सब्सिडी के लालच में कई लोग हैं जो कि लालच कह लो, या आप उसको एक इंसेंटिव कह सकते हो कि एक बेनिफिट हमें सरकार दे रही है, तो व्हाई नॉट यूज दैट बेनिफिट. ऑलराइट, सो इससे इन्वेस्टमेंट भी बढ़ी है टेक्सटाइल इंडस्ट्री में विद द लॉन्च ऑफ दिस स्कीम. रिमेंबर, दिस स्कीम वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 1999, इट वॉज अमेंडेड इन द ईयर 2016, एंड इट वॉज वंस अगेन अमेंडेड इन द ईयर 2018. So if anyone asks you, when was the scheme launched? 1999. And how many amendments have been made? 2. One in 2016 and one in 2018. Then funding. From 2016 to 2022. 2016 se leke 2022 tak ka abhi tak iska implementation period hai. Theek hai? After the amendment done in 2016. So for that period, for these 6-7 years, the total amount is, total outlay for this is 17,822 crores, and out of this 17,822 crores, 12,671 crore is committed for the phase 1. Phase 1 kaun sa tha? 2016 se pehle wala. Which was the phase 1? Before 2016. So this much amount, 12,671 crores, is committed for the previous investment jo pehle ho chuki hai, and the rest 5151 crore for the new cases under this particular scheme. Alright. Talking more about this, so there is a platform, there is a portal through which this scheme is being implemented, which is known as iTufts platform. And administration ki baat kar le, so it is being administered by a two stage ki nigrani hai iske upar rakhi ja rahi hai. Number one is technical advisory cum monitoring committee and inter ministerial steering committee. So it is being implemented under two stage monitoring, जिसमें number one कौन है? Technical advisory cum monitoring committee, and then we have inter ministerial steering committee. Okay, so this was about the scheme, and now let's come back to the question. So you have to identify the incorrect statement. The scheme was launched in 1991. No, it was not in 1991. It was in 1999 that it was launched, and it was amended in the year 2016, and some new features were added in the year 2018. The total outlay of the scheme is 17822 crores. This is absolutely correct. It is being implemented through web-based iTubs platform. Yes, this is the portal through which it is being implemented. And the period of implementation of the scheme is up to 2025. It is not 2025, it's 2022. Till now, and definitely, jab hum 2022 mein pahunchenge, the scheme will be extended. But till now, the implementation period is up to the year 2022. So 1 and 4 are incorrect, which means option D will be the correct answer. Now moving ahead to question number 5. And now question number 5, 6 and 7, guys, we do not have to go into the details. जस्ट जो क्वेश्चन है उसका आंसर याद रखना और जो भी एक दो लाइन में बताऊंगा वो याद रखना. दैट इज इट. वी डोंट हैव टू गो इनटू द डिटेल्स एंड डू रिमेंबर द क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 एंड 7 आर फॉर द नबार्ड एस्पिरेंट्स. जो नबार्ड के एस्पिरेंट्स हैं उनके लिए ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है. या फिर क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 एंड 7 कैन ऑल्सो बी आस्क्ड इन फेज 1 ऑफ एनी एग्जाम. फॉर फेज 2 द क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 एंड 7 आर नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट. इंसॉल्वेंसी एंड बैंकरप्सी बोर्ड ऑफ इंडिया हैज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड 2 डेज Train the Trainers program in association with Foreign Commonwealth and Development Office of Dash. You have to fill the gas. You have to fill the gap. Foreign Commonwealth and Development Office of which country? Okay, this is the question. Now remember, this Train the Trainers program is nothing but a capacity building program. It is a capacity building program for the office bearers of Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. That's it. And it has been organized in association with Foreign Commonwealth and Development Office of United Kingdom. Option D is the correct answer to this question. ठीक है, option D. इतना ही पढ़ना है, इसमें इससे ज़्यादा पढ़ने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. Just remember the name of the program, Train the Trainers, IBBI, in association with Office of UK. That's it. Question number 6. This is important for this is most important for NABARD exam, upcoming mains exam, but yes, it can be asked in other exams as well. मैं ये नहीं कह रहा हूँ. Who has launched Azadi Amrit Chai in Orthodox Elaichi, Adrak and Masala flavors? These are the 4 flavors of this Azadi Amrit Chai. Developed by Messrs. Andrew Yule and Company Limited. This is, guys, more than 150 years old company. It is a central public sector enterprise in tea sector. In tea sector under the Ministry of Heavy Industry. Ministry of Heavy Industries. And who is the Minister of Heavy Industries, by the way? It's Dr. Mahendra Nath Pandey. So who has launched this? It's the Minister of Heavy Industries who has launched this new brand of tea, which is known as Azadi Amrit Chai. And it has been launched on the occasion of course, Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, the 75th year of independence. And question number 7, it is completely for NABARD. In which district of Gujarat, India's first Bunny Buffalo IVF calf is born? India ka pehla, dekho, Bunny Buffalo ek buffalo ka breed hai. And for that, India's first IVF calf is born. So the question is, in which district it happened? It happened in Somnath district. Option E, Somnath district of Gujarat is the correct answer. Alright. And that's it for the session, guys, today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you on Friday. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.